Hello everyone, this is Chensey and welcome to my second devlog of the Princess of Seas, Generating Terrains. This time I will show you how I generate the basic shape of the world. If you are the first time watching my video, please consider subscribing. There will be more devlogs of my game every month. Before we start, I want to list the basic steps of how I generate the terrains. Generate Perlin noise from the thin air. Calculate sea level to decide land and sea. Cut the land on the two geographical poles. Shift the terrain for a better view, and fill the lakes. By doing all the steps, we can get the data to generate a world. That sounds a bit complex, but don't worry, I will go through them one by one. To procedurally generate a world, we need a basic approach to determine the shape of the land. There are several ways to do that. The best approaches I know are Perlin noise diagram and Perlin noise. Perlin noise will generate some random value for further process. All the value generated are ranged from 0 to 1. It is us that decide how to use these values. For example, if we treat the noise value as the height of each cell, we will get a terrain. We can also use the number as a chance to spawn treasures. A cell with a higher value can spawn more precious items. We could also add a threshold, say, valuable resources only appear with a value greater than 0.99. That could be a good solution to generate treasures all over the world. On the other hand, Perlin noise diagram will divide the whole area into several small sections. We can use them as the land and sea directly, or break it into some smaller parts and assign some details to it. Well, for Princess of Seas, I would like to pick the Perlin noise method, because it is easier to create a smoother coastal line in the world, and it is easier to implement it. Just generate a Perlin noise from Oblivion. Do a Gaussian blur to make it smooth. We will use the value as the height of the world. It means these dark parts will become the ocean and the bright area as the land. Cool, we have some data to start with. The next step is to decide the proportion of land and sea. Actually, it is something we need to worry about. Say, in the Phantom Hourglass, most of the area is occupied by the sea and only a few islands are floating on the water. But just a decade later, you see, the water is mostly evaporated, and the Hyrule world is 90% of the land. So you can easily learn that drinking water is good for your health. You can see that the proportion of land and sea can vary for different games. As for the Princess of Sea, I can use the proportion of the real world, which is roughly 7% of the ocean and 30% of the continent. In terms of development, there's an easy way to do that. Put all the height value into a list. Sort the list so the values are arranged in order. Pick the value that is at the 7% position of the whole list. That value is the height of the sea level. Any cells has a higher value will become land, and the rest will be swallowed by water. We now have the world split into land and sea, but there is a small problem. Look at here. The land goes all the way to the border of the map and suddenly it stops. This is terrible, we must fix it. We have two solutions. One is to decrease the height of the land near the border, so there is no land but only water. The other one, on the contrary, is to force the land generated on each side of the world and block the player from the awkward scenery. After some balancing, comparison, and testing in the game, I decide to cut the land and force the port to be a part of the ocean. The approach is simple. Just reduce the height of the cells near the pole and the land will be submerged under the water. What's next? Well, look. This is a map of the real world. The cartographer will try to make the land in the middle of the map and have both sides to be the sea. By doing this, the land will now be cut on the edge and it looks much better. I want to do the same to my map. And here are the steps. Calculate the number of land cells by each column. and pick the one with the least land in it. Then shift the map accordingly. It looks better now. The last step is to fill the lake. Before I go through this part, I want to declare that environmental protection is very important. Filling a lake in the real world may not be acceptable. However, for a sailing game, I really don't think we should leave the lake on the map, cause the player may wonder if they could reach the inner lake with some special operations, or if they could find some secretly hidden treasures there. Well, please play the game the way it is designed. Understand? To fill the lake, I need to pick all the cells that are marked as the sea. Calculate the size of each sea, or lake, or pool, whatever. Pick the water area with the largest size. This is the sea we want. For the rest, we will set the height value of the cells so they are land instead of seas. Okay, now the world looks better. I think that's enough for today. Please press like and do subscribe if you like my game. I will post my thoughts and progress during the development. The link to the game is in the description. See you next time.